What's up, geeks, and welcome to the channel. Say the interviewer provides you with the headnote of a singly linked list and asks you to reverse that list. One obvious solution you may think of may be to reverse the list by retrieving the last node of the given list one node at a time until there are no more nodes left. So in this example, we will first retrieve node 5 and set it to be the root of our reversed list, followed by node 2, then node 8, and so on. To implement this, we simply traverse the list all the way to the end. This was done via getTheLastNodeHelper method you see. As soon as we encounter a null node, we return its parent. This will allow us to break the link between them, removing the node from the initial list as we just saw, and use it to build our new list. The first invocation of this method will return with the new head node the user is expecting. Then this method is called with every iteration inside a loop of your choice, allowing us to append the detached last node from the initial list to the reversed list we are constructing. Okay, this solution works. However, you might have guessed that it is not optimal at all. And to improve the complexity of this logic, you may choose to trade time for space. So, instead of going back and forth every time to fetch the last node, we can store all these nodes in a stack while traversing this list once. Then, after doing that, we pop the top element every time while linking the nodes together. The new list formed will represent the traversed version of the initial given one. To adapt our previous implementation, we can replace the call to the getLastNode method with a logic that populates a stack we created with the nodes we have. The first element we pop will be the head of our reversed list. Then, continuously popping elements from the stack will allow us to generate the reversed list in a linear space and time complexity. Okay, our thought process and everything we've written until now will work just fine. But what if I tell you that this can be further improved, that there is a way to reverse this list in place in linear time? You see, linked lists are basically a few nodes connected with the next attribute located inside each node. So if we were able to change that next pointer, let's say in node 7 to reference node 4 instead of 3, and in node 4 to reference null instead of 7, then these two nodes would be correctly linked for our reversed target list, right? And if we manage to do that for the whole list, then that list would be reversed in place. Isn't that simple and elegant? To implement this solution, we will need to keep track of the previous node of each one we traverse, and the previous of the head will start off as null. This node also represents the next node of the tail of our reversed list, which is supposed to be null. So the new next node of the current node or head will be that previous node, which starts as null. But before losing the connection to the other nodes forever, we need to store their leading node inside a temp variable. This way, when we move on to the next two nodes to update, we will still have a reference to it. And that's it. The head of our reversed list will be the last element we traversed, which is now stored inside the prev variable. Okay, after answering this question, the interviewer may choose to scale things up in several directions and several ways. And the first attempt they may do is ask you to modify this logic to be able to reverse nodes between two given indices inside a list. So, the method parameters will look like this, meaning that the reverse operation should only be applied between the nodes located at the left and right positions. One way to solve this problem, all while making use of the logic we just wrote, is to shift the initial position of the current and previous pointers we previously used until they reach the proper starting point in the list, which is the left position. As soon as they do, we keep reversing the nodes of the list until we reach the right position. This is done by making use of the same exact logic we previously wrote and by decrementing our right counting pointer. After this, the last node we were at before we started reversing should now point to the head node of the reversed sublist, and the tail of the reversed list should point to the first node located after the right position, right? To apply these connections, we must initially keep track of this information and use it to adjust the final connections of our list, as you can see in front of you. With that, our problem is solved. Now, the second attempt that can be done by the interviewer if they were really looking to raise the bar is ask you to reverse the nodes in k groups. What does this mean? Well, take this list as an example and suppose our k variable is 3. So, the nodes should be reversed in groups of 3, meaning the first 3 nodes are reversed individually, then the next 3 nodes, and so on. Okay, to tackle and implement this problem, we must take into consideration two main things. First, we already know how to reverse a list or a sublist, so we must leverage on this and try to make use of the logic we previously wrote. In this case, we can implement this part as a for loop that reverses any given k nodes in the list. The second and most important thing is repetition, implying the need for recursion. You see, once we figure out how to reverse the first k nodes, all we need to do is apply the same logic on all the following nodes. So, after reversing, we check if the next batch of nodes exists, then we call the same method we are currently implementing on them. This will allow us to reverse the next k nodes that appear in this list. And this is the main logic of our method. However, now we need to consider one last corner case. You see, if the batch we are trying to reverse is made of, let's say, 2 nodes, but our k is equal to 3, then we shouldn't reverse these 2 nodes, and the head node or list must be returned as is. This is done in a simple while loop right before the reverse logic, in which we check if the number of nodes left in the list is bigger than k. If it isn't, we simply return with the head node, and if it is, we proceed to the logic we just wrote. The links to the LeetCode problems we solved today can be found in the description below. Let me know your thoughts and suggestions for upcoming videos in the comments section. And that's it for today. I hope it was helpful. Thank you guys for watching. Take care, and I will see you in the next one.